Welcome back. You're live on Urban Television, of course, with Deedan and Mckenzie. We're still going on with Urban today. Remember, we are on Twitter at 90, we're on Twitter at Urban TV Uganda when you have too many jobs. This life of a hustler. And the hashtag is Urban Today. Make sure you tag at Miss Deedan and at Keller Mckenzie. We're also on Facebook. That is at Urban Leave a Space Television. Like that page. You get to see a lot of behind the scenes, by the way. Now, earlier on, Mckenzie was talking about marketing. Our spoken word was also talking about marketing. And today in studio, we do have somebody very special. And I've even been asking questions. How comes we've never had this before? It's just starting now. I'm talking about the president of the Uganda Marketeers Society right here in our studios. Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
It is good to have you.
It's a pleasure to be here.
Are you looking bright and fresh?
Proper.
Very happy, eh?
Absolutely.
It's a new beginning.
It's like you woke up yesterday.
You woke up, you know, by the way, the guy was ready yesterday.
I'm sure, Mckenzie, you had to throw in there.
Good to see you.
So it's good to have you
it's
here.
It's a pleasure to be here.
It is.
Absolutely.
I'm seeing the excitement and what is actually, as we were talking before we started,
right.
What is shocking me is, how comes we've never had a marketing society in Uganda?
As a matter of fact, yeah, I mean, that's the question. It was just about time. We have the lawyers, society,
yes.
we have engineers, doctors,
we have...
Mama Fina has one as well.
Very soon, we're also starting TV presenters.
Most definitely.
Yeah, we'll come
to
you for assistance.
I think it was about time that the marketers come together as well,
yes.
Into a professional society that can, you know, regulate the practice of marketing in Uganda.
Now, yes. funny thing is, you were saying something earlier. I don't know if you got to watch it while you were waiting to come in. You were saying a lot of Ugandans confuse sales and marketing.
You know, there's so many people in Uganda who consider themselves marketers.
Absolutely.
And they some people actually end up spoiling the image of that.
Yeah. Let's,
before we actually get into that, just tell us a bit about yourself. First of all, how you got into this business.
Well, it's not a business per se. It's
that's the thing. you can break it down for us.
Absolutely. So,
yeah.
My name is John Paul Okwi, and I work with MTN Uganda
yes.
in marketing, in charge of sponsorship and events.
Okay.
But also, I do some consultancy with the Uganda Management Institute on the Chartered Institute of Marketing program.
Okay.
So, I've been in marketing for the last 7 or so years.
Wow.
And having done this professional program called CIM,
okay.
You know, accredited from the UK.
Okay. That is in detail, CIM being?
Chartered Institute of Marketing.
Okay.
Yeah, it's a professional accreditation program for marketers.
Okay. Okay.
Just like there is for SCCA for accountants and CIPs, or SIPs, I think it is, for procurement professionals.
Yes. Yeah.
Marketers have one as well.
Okay.
So having done this program, we realized that, you know, there's a bit of a discrepancy between, you know, the profession as marketing and what we perceive here in Uganda
as marketing.
And rightfully, as you alluded, Mckenzie, the perception is that we are so trade-oriented, trading, you know, sales and, you know, anyone who can hawk some products around.
That's
not to say that that does not involve marketing.
It should involve marketing, but for some reason, it's seen as the actual marketing.
Absolutely.
And I think that's why it goes wrong. Why did you get yourself involved in this? Why did you think I have to be a part of this and start this?
Well, first and foremost, you will realize that marketing in whatever scope for big businesses or small businesses somehow is the pivot. It's a central, it's a driving agenda for many businesses. Whether when you visit a shop, when you visit a market, for some reason or the other, you're going to be influenced by some marketing process.
That's true.
Somewhere. Whether you do it consciously or not, you are impacted. And it's very important that the people behind these processes are actually professional and that they have a strict code of conduct, just like other professions, engineers and all that kind of stuff. And that there is a body of knowledge that they subscribe to. Why? Because our domain, our environment, Mckenzie, is continually changing.
Yeah.
Just a couple of years ago, there was no digital. Yeah. Now it's the own thing.
Yeah.
You know, digital right now is taking over and it's changing the entire landscape. So
that's true.
As marketers, if you are not up to date with this information, you're going to be
stay in the back.
You're going to be caught like a deer in the headlamps. Eh?
Yeah.
You're going to be.
So
please. So what exactly does the society entail, if I may ask? Like, what are these rules you're talking about? Like, you have to abide by certain regulations?
Well, I think rules is a...
It's a tough word.
A big word.
Yes, it is.
So let's say regulations let's or some of the things you respect.
Let's call them a code of conduct.
Okay.
And integrity, for instance.
Okay.
Professionalism entails that you have to say the truth, for instance.
Yeah.
Things like...
How truth is the truth?
Well, that is what we define. For example, we help our members appreciate that, you know, deceptive marketing, advertising,
okay.
Can be, well, it could benefit you in the short run, but mm-hmm. sustainably, and mm-hmm. this is what we want to prioritize as marketing,
mm-hmm.
as a marketing profession, will not get you far.
Mm-hmm.
So you could, you know, be deceptive today, make your product move on the market,
mm-hmm.
but tomorrow
yeah.
you're certainly
you're
gonna bite the dust.
What's the difference with this? What's the difference with marketing, promotion, and sales?
So I'll tell you what. Marketing, promotion, and sales are all aspects of
under the same
aspect of marketing.
Talk about advertising, talk about PR,
branding.
Talk about brand, products, pricing.
Mm.
All these elements fall under the you know, the leadership of marketing.
Okay.
This is why I think people get confused.
Yes.
Because you can never really tell where the line...
They do.
Yeah.
And sometimes people, like, we have other bodies, like Uganda Advertisers Association.
Mm-hmm. Mm.
We have the PROW. And all these are facets of marketing.
Yes.
Yeah.
You know, there are people that deal with pricing, there are people that deal with promotions, there are people who deal with... you know, even the aesthetics and cosmetics of your office,
mm.
yeah.
it's marketing.
It's marketing.
Yeah. So marketing is the broader, you know, approach to the.
So now, if I'm before I get lost any further, if I was to ask Mckenzie, for example,
yeah, ask him.
What is a marketer or what is marketing?
Yeah.
What is the simplest way you would
break
advise him to answer me?
Yeah.
Well, I'm not too sure about Mckenzie, but
I would say marketing is to be able
to sell
to
sand to somebody in the desert.
Your choice of you know if you want to buy. I cannot put it in words. I'll be honest with you because I would consider myself in the business of marketing in a way somewhere somehow because when you're doing a show like this. You have to find a way of marketing
Absolutely.
So there is some type of selfies we take on some days. There's some type of videos we take on some other days.
Absolutely.
And we consider that marketing.
Yep.
But would I call myself a marketer? You get what I mean?
Yeah,
like that's where
exactly.
we're going. Like if someone is, let's say, promoting a show, like these music shows that are in town.
Right.
Someone
right.
is promoting it and
right.
everything.
I mean, they've done advertisements.
And they've done advertisement, they've done everything on their own sometimes.
Yeah.
Would you call that person a marketer? And would they fall under this?
So suddenly, Mckenzie is a brand, eh? So
yeah.
he needs a marketer.
Yeah.
Oh,
yes. I get what you're saying. I see where you're going.
Now you're going to make this
no,
very important.
This guy.
Please, go down.
Legit brand.
Let's keep him there.
Yeah. At the end of the day, what all those people are doing is marketing.
Okay.
Unfortunately, the challenge is that sometimes it's siloed, you know. The guy who's doing promotions is just doing a bit
a
of promotion.
Specific
yeah.
bit
just
of
some
marketing.
Small bit of it.
Okay.
And they perhaps think that is the, you know, it's not integrated. It's
okay.
not, well, but you know, marketing is about, you know, taking the selfies
mm-hmm.
because your profile and personality is very important.
Yeah.
But it's also about dressing right. It's
yeah.
probably also about, you know, talking right.
Yeah.
It's about being knowledgeable and
mm-hmm.
all that kind of
mm.
stuff. So it's a whole ballpark.
It's a whole
yeah.
ballpark.
But it's also really also about understanding who your audience is, for
okay.
instance, and,
yeah.
and knowing that your fans out there would love you to speak like
yeah.
you do,
yeah.
Dress like you do,
yeah.
mm.
and you know anticipate their needs, and then you meet them
yeah.
By taking you know your selfies and,
yeah.
and looking nice on TV
mm-hmm.
and
yeah.
that kind of stuff. So
okay.
you meet their needs
mm-hmm.
Inevitably, and you even try to anticipate what they would probably be thinking about next. The
yeah.
next day or
that's
next
true.
It's
absolutely.
A lot.
Then
you can see
yeah.
marketing
so
is quite
yeah,
big.
It's quite big because I'm looking at the PROs, I'm looking at all these other people.
Absolutely.
They end up they might end up going under this umbrella.
That's
and
true.
I think why it has been a bit very hard.
Yes.
For me I'll be very honest. I think the reasons why it has been very hard, it's been hard to define. And when it's hard to define, I think that's why you find that there's not been a particular umbrella to cover it up.
That's true. That's
so when there's an accountant, you really know what the accountant
Absolutely.
Does.
Absolutely.
When there's a lawyer, you really know what the lawyer
Absolutely.
Does.
Mm.
When they say that you're a marketer, sometimes I'm like, exactly what field? Mm-hmm. So would you say someone is a marketer and then they have a particular field they're working in?
They concentrate on.
Absolutely. I mean, that is why the UMS, the Uganda Marketers Society, actually,
yes.
We're here to bring clarity to the profession. It's a very detailed discipline. And yes, there are people that are in creative. There are people that are focusing on innovation.
Yes.
There are people that focus on pricing. Mm-hmm. There are people that are gurus at trade marketing. There are people that focus on digital.
Yeah.
Just like we are going to be having this event on the 15th.
Exactly. Yeah.
It's really focused on data and digital. They are specialists.
The new age.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. But the ability to bring all these facets together and put them together is really the skill that's inherent in marketing.
Okay.
And making sure that they are all aligned and working for the cause of the business or the brand or whatever you're trying to market.
So standardized, we need to have a standard.
I guess.
Absolutely.
You've talked about this society coming up, but I do believe we're going to be going into a small break.
Yeah. Sure,
and absolutely. Then when we do come back, most probably, let's get into what you're calling the fireplace.
Mm-hmm.
Why the fireplace?
I saw that and I was like,
I was like, fireplace.
It's going to be fire.
Yeah, we're cooking. Is it a barbecue? I'm like, marketers have fun.
You know?
Or don't they?
They might be turning up.
They're turning up without us.
Listen, man, when we come back after the break, we'll be looking at the 15th of September. That's this Friday. A huge deal that is happening in the marketing world. Yes, we shall be right back. Keep it close, Urban Today.